Good afternoon.
My name is Cesar Sanchez.
And my name is Juan Pablo Guaracao.
We are presenting leadership, so hope you like it. So, well, the first of our presentation is based on a key project, which is called TESMON, which is Model United Nations from the English School. So, in the session of the morning, I was a presentation about Model United Nations, right? From a student from Anglui, right? Yeah. Could you say your name?
Isabella.
Yeah, Isabella, show us something about Model United Nations. So, we're giving a different focus in this presentation, so hope you like it. That was the promotional video for TESMON, which just passed. It was in October 22nd to the 25th. As you saw, it was from 16 committees, almost 1,000 participants from different parts of Colombia and from four different countries. Three different countries. Yeah.
Well, each year, during the final days of October, the TESMON conference is held. So, well, one of our main aims is basically we try to create the world leaders of today, not the adverse leaders of tomorrow. Not only we want to emphasize leadership, but also we want to make an ethical leadership, to develop ethical qualities between the delegates.
So it's important to highlight that in the future, some leaders which weren't developed, as well as the leaders who attend Model United Nations, are the ones who are going to help develop society in a good way. So the best delegates are prepared, the best leaders we're going to have. So what's TESMON? It's a United Nations simulation, as Isabella just stated some hours ago. But it's a controversial point, it's leadership. And a student who is a leader, it's a successful student in Model United Nations. The first root of this, it's student leadership. Inside school, we have a TESMON committee, which is coordinated by our teacher, which is right beside us, whose name is Diana Garcia. we have students who all across school lead this kind of activity, who invite schools, talk to politicians, talk to headmistress, to headmasters all over Colombia, to invite them to attend to TESMON every year.
Well, it is indeed a tough work to do because it is coordinated mostly. It is done mostly by students. It is coordinated by a teacher. But we as students have to invite everyone, have to make almost the whole conference itself. So it is a really long and harsh process for us. Well, the next topic is global awareness. It is basically the academic part of Model United Nations. In Model United Nations, several topics are being treated. Some of them refer to economics or to international affairs, or even sometimes to domestic reasons, specifically more in Colombia, because, well, the conference is held in Colombia. We tried to deal with economics, as I said before. There are some specific committees we tried to recreate in the Model UN. Let's say the economic committee is ECOFIN, ECOSOC, but also there are also other bodies of the United Nations, the United Nations Security Council, the DICE Committee, or other committees referred to in international relations.
Yeah, Well, what's important about to highlight about Tasman is the social part that we have. That well, I don't know a model United Nations we has that kind of a part that we have. It's social awareness. Students who attend Tasman have the possibility to know people who are from really difficult conditions, living conditions, from Colombia. So they get that part of social awareness, which is really important for us to be a balanced person during life. Like, knowing reality of a country makes you a good citizen. So we try to focus on that. So here are some pictures from last Tasman. The eighth graders are really important part from our curriculum. This is us in the opening ceremony. well, I want to stop here. I want you to know this guy. His name is Brian Garcia. He's from a little town in Cauca, Miranda, Cauca. I know him since, I don't know, like last 2 years, but I know him since February. He really, really worked hard for him to travel from a little town in Miranda, which is really, really, apart from a city, and it's affected directly by internal conflict here in Colombia, like guerrillas and narc traffic, those kind of stuff. He worked along with his classmates to really, like, attending Tasman and having some, like, for us, suits and that kind of stuff, like having cash or something like that. It's pretty simple. But for them, like, taking out the suit was really, really difficult. Like, he needed to go and ask for money for his parents, his grandma, everyone. And there are some kids that come from also from Amazonas who can't even buy their own suit, but they need to take their fathers and use them. So, we want to show the development of leadership skills that Tasman program has. So, well, the most important one, at my point of view, it's leading groups. Every student in Tasman, it's a leader, no matter what he's doing. So, being a leader, it's always going to be needed in life, I think so, and helpful. So that's what we focus on.
Yes, and, well, there's not only the delegates who are leaders, the type of social awareness which we referred, so really impacts each and every participant of the conference itself. I also agree with my mate Cesar. I also believe leading groups is the most important factor that we develop in MUN conferences. But also there are some other important ones, as you may see. Teamwork. Delegates are required to make working papers or possible resolutions to any topic in teams. They divide into political blocks with similar ideologies, and they try to solve a problem that is part of the UN agenda itself. So in the end, they have to develop some kind of social skills, some teamwork, in order for them to cooperate and make the final and best solution. Next is to improve the task quality. MUN is not only about speaking, about having body language, persuasive language, it's also to have excellent writing skills. Because whenever you write a working paper or any sort of document that is going to be used in the committee, you need to have excellent grammar, excellent spelling, because there are other people who are going to see that actual document. So it needs to be really clear for each and every participant. Continuing, there is the advocacy and analytical skills. Advocacy, well, for those who don't know it, is to represent, to have a voice for those communities around the world who may not have the voice in that conference at all. So in some committees, we try to represent, students try to represent Palestinian communities who are being affected by the Israeli-Palestinian conflict, or Amazon communities who have been affected by deforestation. We try to have a voice for them. Also, analytical skills is not to know the information, it's also to interpret that information and to communicate that information.
interactions, it's important. Like, I'm gonna tell you a little story. I know this guy from Caucasus, the one I show you, Brian. In that conference in 2009, which October, he first met someone who was from outside Colombia. Like, it was delegates from who were from Ecuador and Chile and Mexico, right, from the master school. Yeah, so it was really important for him to know and like understand the fact that there's somewhere outside that map he has in classroom, which is Colombian map, there's something outside that. And knowing people with, from a different culture, like Chile and Mexico, was really important for him. I also want to emphasize the fact which about social responsibility and education for sustainable development.
Well, I'm going to explain a bit more about Education for Sustainable Development, also named ESD. There are certain committees which are based on topics regarding the environment. So mainly, the most important one is the UNEP committee, United Nations Environmental Program, where delegates itself do not debate about economic reasons, they debate about the environment, which is a topic on the UN agenda, and a topic which we all probably know, which is affecting us and which will affect us in not the distant future.
Tesmun helps develop between having assimilation and conflict resolution. It discusses or creates for discussing and creating an action plan and strategic plan towards solving real issues. So those kinds of skills and abilities you develop in Tesmun or even though in all MUN conference helps you to, well, have conflict resolution in your life. Well, we want to emphasize on the fact that we know that not even Tesmun, but the whole planet Earth, it's now interconnected and it's being moved in a globalized society. So creating social networks for actions and plans are some kind of, well, I don't know, like tracks for people to develop ideas and solutions to global programs. So, and they were just invited by two men, you know them, Mark Zuckerberg from Facebook and Jack Dorsey, who was the founder of Twitter. I want to explain this. As you know, probably most of you know them. If not, this is Bogota, our city. This city, which really has some big problems. So in Tesmun we have a committee which is called Comisión Bogotá. We have a certain committee which debates upon local problematics, which help us solve problems from our city, Bogotá. Because if we want to solve problems for countries, it's important to start from our house. And our house is this city.
Well, these are just some important factors because, well, as in Tesmun, in MUN conferences, we no longer become members of our community. We become members of the world. We become world citizens. And, well, these are just some important factors that we take into account. The first one is technology. Technology is a really important issue. As mentioned in previous talks, it helps in two ways. Academically, delegates mentioned technology a lot of times as an answer, especially for environmental issues. Technology and green technology helps a lot. But also, like in a more personal level, technology also helps the delegate itself because it's an excellent method for communicating. And whenever a delegate comes to the conferences, in the end, you made a new friend. You made friends in the committee, and you keep on talking with them through Facebook or any other social network. Also, there is the international affairs and diplomacy, which is, well, most of the topics that are being treated in the commissions, in the committees. Some of them regard security, others regard sustainable development, others regard the role of women, human rights in certain countries, refugees. So we try to make people aware of the global situation the world is living right now. Well, Next one is the economy. Well, I personally like a lot economics, and it's not for the reason of mathematics. It's also for a really specific reason, and it's because economics probably has no answer at all. There is no perfect answer to the economic problem of scarcity, of poverty. And delegates come with so many ideas just to try to find a solution to a problem who economists and people in the real United Nations are trying to work on.
I think we have to move on. We don't have so much time. But these factors make us world citizens, which are going to be the 21st century leaders. That's our objective. That's Tasman objective, and that's what MUN conference is all about. Now, figures of leadership are figures of inspiration and commitment. In the United Nations, Secretary General Ban Ki-moon and Ex-Secretary General Kofi Annan. New, challenging, different ideals, but all for a good cause.
These are just some of the world leaders who, well, in fact, had new ideas, who changed the world. Some benefited, some don't.
Well, some hours ago, they talked about Dominican Republic. We figured out that President Leonel Fernandez was once delegate from MUN conferences in Dominican Republic, and due to his experience, he studied politics. After finishing all his studies, and well, having a political career, he became president of the Dominican Republic. So it's important to highlight that it doesn't matter if you are simulating to be a country, if you are being a delegate, you can reach real politics if you want. If you are a true leader, you can.
Well, finally, MUN is not only in Colombia, it's around the world, and it helps people develop their abilities, their qualities, in such a way that, well, in each country there's an MUN conference. And universities themselves, they usually like the MUN profile, the profile an MUN student have. So, well, these are just some of the conferences we attended to. Harvard MUN, HMUN, Yale MUN, Y MUN, and, well, CMonkey, which is Columbia University.
Well, last year, it was the first time I myself attended to CMonkey, Juan Pablo too. So we have some pictures from last year we wanted to show you. And finally, the English school has its own model, United Nations. It's called Tasman, as you've heard. Next year, October 2013, Tasman 10, with 10 years of Tasman. So before ending our presentation, I would like to call Diana Garcia for telling you a little bit more about Tasman 10.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. I feel very happy to be here. It's just for a couple of minutes, but thanks for the space you have given us. Basically, the idea of me attending in this moment is inviting you to our new conference, Tasman 10. It's going to be a special conference since we're going to celebrate our 10 years. It's going to be about 20 committees. We hope you can come. This year, we had schools from Chile, Ecuador, and Mexico. The experience was very good, so we're very glad. We will be very glad to have you here. With Cesar and Juan Pablo, I'm leaving a bag in which you will find the formal invitation, the formal letter of invitation, and some materials that we would like to share with you and the teachers that travel with you this time. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your attention.